Lattice realization of IAR filter. A question is given like that. The transfer function h of z is equal to 1 by 1 plus 0.9 z inverse minus 0.8 z raised to minus 2 plus 0.5 z raised to minus 3. This is the transfer function given. We want to determine the equivalent lattice structure of all pole IAR filter. Okay, we want to find out the equivalent lattice structure of the above transfer function. From the question, it is clear that it is a third order system. That is, the value of n is equal to 3, and the a3 of z is equal to 1 plus the denominator term, the denominator of the transfer function, that is 1 plus 0.9 z raised to minus 1 minus 0.8 z raised to minus 2 plus 0.5 z raised to minus 3. Okay, the last video I discussed about the major equations, that is am minus 1 of z is equal to am of z minus km bm of z by 1 minus km square. This is the equation for finding out the am minus 1 of z term. Okay, now let's do the problem. The first step is to, it is a third order system, right? So we want to find out K3. It is a third order system, so the first step is to find out K3, then to find K2, then K1. Okay, if it is a fourth order system, we want to find out K4, then K3, K2, K1. Okay, so what is the first step? Your first step is to find out K3. So K3, the general equation, I will write the general equation one more time. We know that am minus 1 of z is equal to am of z minus km bm of z by 1 minus km square. Okay. This is the general equation for finding out am minus 1 of z. Okay. So what is the value of m is? It is a third order system. So, it is a third order system. The value of m is 3. So, am of z is equal to the denominator term of the transfer function. That is 1 plus 0.9 z inverse minus 0.8 z raised to minus 2 plus 0.5 z raised to minus 3. How will you find out the K3 term? That is, this value is the K3 term, that is 0.5. What is the coefficient of z raised to minus 3? That is the value of K3. Okay, that is K3 is equal to 0.5. Okay, this is our first step. Okay, it is directly, we get it from the question itself, that is, what is the maximum power of the coefficient, maximum power coefficient, z inverse of minus 3, the coefficient is 0.5, that is the value of K3. So the next step is to find the value of K2, to find K2 value. For finding out the K2 value, I am writing the equation one more time. Am minus 1 of z is equal to am of z minus km bm of z by 1 minus km square. Okay, so we know m value is 3, so k3 values we already found, it is 0.5. so am minus 1 of z means m is 3, m is equal to 3. So am minus 1 means a2 of z is equal to am of z, that is a3 of z minus k3 b3 of z by 1 minus k3 square. Okay, this is the equation for finding out a2 of z. After finding out a2 is z, the coefficient of z raised to minus 2, that is the value of k2. So first, we need to find out a2 of z. For that, A2 of Z, for getting A2 of Z, first we need to find out B3 of Z. Okay, B3 of Z is nothing but, if we write what is the equation given, denominator term, what is the denominator term? 1 plus 0.9 Z inverse minus 0.8 Z raised to minus 2 plus 0.5 Z raised to minus 3. Okay, this is the given equation. Okay, if we write this equation in the reverse order in such a fashion, that is 0.5 without writing the Z term. Okay, 0.5 plus sign, the plus sign plus 0.5, don't write this. Then next term is 0.8 minus 0.8. Okay, that is Z raised to minus 1. Okay, what is the next term? Plus 0.9, then Z raised to minus 2. Okay, then what is the next term? 1, that is plus 1 Z raised to minus 3. This is the B3 of Z value. Just write the equation in the reverse order, that is 0.5 minus 0.8 plus 0.9 1. Okay, then first don't write this coefficient, then Z inverse, then Z raised to minus 2, then Z raised to minus 3. If there is another term, write Z raised to minus 4. Such a way that we are reversing the equation and writing. This is the value of our B3 of Z. Okay, that is B3 of Z is equal to, we got it as, there is one more equation for finding out B3 of Z. That is, we are multiplying Z raised to minus 3, then with A3 of Z inverse. Okay, that is Z inverse is equal to, what is the value of AM of Z? 1 plus 0.9 Z. Don't write the inverse term, simply write the positive term. 0.9 Z minus 0.8 Z square plus 0.5 Z raised to cube. Then multiplying it with Z raised to minus 3, we will be getting Z raised to minus 3 plus 0.9 Z raised to minus 2 minus 0.8 Z raised to minus 1 plus 0.5. So same the answer we got by reversing the equation. Okay, either way you can do it. The better way is to do like this. The given equation, reverse direction, you write all the coefficient, then write in such a way that first without Z term, second term Z inverse, third term Z raised to minus 3, fourth term Z raised to minus 4, like that you go like that. Okay, same equation we will be getting. So this is the value of B3 of Z. Now we get the value of B3 of Z. Now we can find out the value of AM minus 1. That is, AM minus 1 means A2 of Z, which is equal to, what is the first? AM of Z. AM of Z means A3 of Z minus KM. KM means K3. BM of Z means B3 of Z by 1 minus KM square. That is K3 square, which is equal to, what is the value of A3 of Z? The given denominator term, that is 1 plus 0.9 Z inverse minus 0.8 Z raised to minus 2 plus 0.5 Z raised to minus 3. Okay, that is the A3 of Z minus, what is the value of K3? K3 we already found out, the K3 value is 0.5. That is 0.5 into B3 of Z. We found the B3 of Z, that is 0.5 minus, write that as that equation, that is 0.5 minus 0.8 Z inverse plus 0.9 Z raised to minus 2 plus Z raised to minus 3. Okay, that whole equation divided by 1 minus KM square. KM value, that is K3 value, is 0.5 square. Okay, which is equal to 1 plus 0.9 z raised to minus 1 minus 0.8 z raised to minus 2 plus 0.5 z raised to minus 3 minus, then multiply these whole terms. That is 0.5 into 0.5, 0.25 minus 0.8 into 0.5, 0.4 z raised to minus 1 plus 0.45 z raised to minus 2 plus 0.5 z raised to minus 3 whole divided by 1 minus 0.5 the whole square. Okay, for simplify the equation, for the lack of saving time, for the sake of saving time, I am don't writing the substitution. I am simply directly going to the final answer. That is, we will be getting in such a way that a2 of z is equal to 1 plus 1.73 z raised to minus 1 minus 1.67 z raised to minus 2. This is the equation we got for a2 of z. Okay, then the k2 value is equal to the coefficient of z raised to minus 2, that is minus 1.67. That is minus 1.67 is the value of k2. Similarly, so we got k3 of z, we got k3 coefficient, k2 coefficient. Now we need to find k1 coefficient, that is the again step 3 is to find k1. For that, the same equation am minus already we got a2 of z, so minus 1, that is a1 of z is equal to a2 of z minus b2 of z, sorry, k2 b2 of z by 1 minus k2 square. This is the equation for finding out a1 of z. So a2 of, for that we need to find what value of b2 of z. B2 of z is simply, we know what is the last equation, a2 of z equation. This is the equation for a2 of z. Write all the coefficient in the reverse order. That is, this is the equation. Write it is in the reverse order, means minus 1.67, then plus 1.73, then plus 1. Like that, writing the equation in the reverse order. That is, first writing minus 1.67, no z coefficient. Then the next term is plus 1.73. Plus 1.73, first z inverse term. Then next term is 1. That is 1 into z raised to minus 2. This is the value of b2 of z. Okay. Now, we want to substitute this b2 of z in this equation. Okay. So, b2 of z we got. Now we want to do the a1 of z equation. Will a1 of z is equal to, sorry, a1 of z is equal to a2 of z minus k2 b2 of z by 1 minus k2 square, which is equal to 1 plus 2 by 3 z inverse, a2 of z is what, a2 of z is equal to 1 plus 1.73 z raised to minus 1 minus 1.67 z raised to minus 2 plus the coefficient of k2, that is minus 1.67, that is minus 1.67 into what is the value of b2 of z. B2 of z is minus 1.67 plus 1.73 z inverse plus 1 z raised to minus 2. Write the equation here, that is minus 1.67 plus 1.73 z raised to minus 1 plus z raised to minus 2 whole divided by 1 minus k2 square, that is 1.67 square. Okay, you will be getting an equation like this. After substituting, we will be getting 1 minus 1.62 z raised to minus 1, that is a 1 of z. So the value of k1 is the coefficient of z inverse. Coefficient of z inverse means k1 is equal to minus 1.62. okay, so we got k1, k2 and k3. So we can draw the IAR structure, lattice structure, in such a way that first draw the input term. What is the input term? X of n is the input term. Okay. In the case of lattice structure, the adder terms are put before the delayer terms. Here it is a third order system. First of all, you draw 3 z inverse term. Okay, each term are placed at a distance. Z inverse, z inverse and z inverse. Okay, 3 z terms. Since it is a third order system, draw 3 z inverse term. Then in the case of IAR filter, I already told that the adder terms are coming before to the delay term. So write 2 delay terms here. Okay, then what? Here also, before, prior to the z inverse term, 2 adders are there. Here also, prior to the z inverse term, 2 adders are present. Okay, connect all these things here, here. Okay, this is the output y of n. Okay, then it is connected. This path is going to this direction. Okay, like this, like this, like this, like this. This is in the case of IAR filter. FIR filter, all paths are forward paths. Okay, now we need to draw the K1 coefficient, K2 coefficient. Here IAR filter, one K coefficient is negative because of the reverse path, other is positive itself. So K structures are like this. Here, like this and like this. Here K3 is equal to 0.5. Here K3 is equal to minus 0.5. Okay. Then here we are drawing the K terms. K2 term here, upward term, that is equal to negative of K2. That is, we got K2 as minus of 1.67, minus of minus 1.67, 1.67, and downward we will be getting K2 is equal to minus of 1.67. Then here third coefficient, upward, minus K1. Minus K1 means 1.62. K1 is equal to minus K1 is equal to 1.62. Here minus K2. Here downward, K1 is equal to minus of 1.62. So this is the lattice structure of an IAR filter. Okay, that is, we need to find out K3. If it is a third order system, we need to find the lattice coefficients K3, K2 and K1. After finding out a K2, K3 and K1 coefficients, we are drawing 3 delay terms. That is, since it is a third order system, 3 delay terms are drawing. Since it is an IAR filter, prior to the z inverse term, the adders are putting, and in that one lattice coefficient, that is lattice coefficient going upward is of negative value and going downward is of positive value. Okay, x of n is the input. Here we are taking out the output y of n. The direction is like this, it is going like this, then to this direction. Okay, so this is the lattice structure of an IAR filter.